We got that new train anticipation going today. Wonder what could be inside.
Fragile.
We're going to max speed, 70 miles an hour, fishing line class A.
I think this is worthy of a whistle battle. Welcome back, folks. Hope you're having a great week. This week, we're going to open a big train together. But this is not just any train. No, no, no. This is a Lionel Vision Line engine.
You see it?
If you're looking for one of these train engines, check out trainworld.com because they still have a few left, but they're going to sell out, so you better move fast if you want to get one. Vision Line represents the pinnacle of Lionel engineering as far as their scale trains go, and the engine we're going to open tonight is truly something special. Plus, this is the channel's second birthday, so this is really a train engine for all of us. Cheers. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. First things first, a quick rundown on the components of O-gauge train packaging. You have the shipper box, which protects the train from the trials and tribulations of transport. I recommend that you keep the shipper box. Plus, if you sell the engine down the line, chances are somebody will actually pay you more if you have this box. I know, it's a box outside of a box outside of a box. If you ever open a Vision Line engine, one of the first details you may have noticed is the foam lining around the box. So it's nice to know that all the delicate parts are cradled in the packaging. Once we remove the foam lining, boxes in my face. Once we remove the foam lining, we get to that signature black box, the main event. Lionel boxes are traditionally orange, so you know there's something special when you see this box. Let's get this train out of here, shall we? This is the exciting part. Hang on to that. Even the styrofoam says Vision Line. How epic is that? And there it is, wrapped like a little Vision Line O-gauge burrito. You may notice that not all Lionel engines feature the Lionel paper anymore, but Vision Line keeps it real. It's the details, like I said. I like the paper. I have no words. This is shiny. Gonna be a pain to keep this thing clean. Ready for the engine? I am. There it is, folks. This is a heck of a machine. I'm gonna need a few minutes to take this all in. It was packed really well. You had a long journey, my friend. Welcome home. Before we run any new engine, we need to apply a little bit of oil just to make sure everything runs well. Now, what we're going to want to do is carefully rotate the engine over. Lots of little parts. So when you do this, be careful. We're going to want to remove the packing styrofoam. Easy peasy. I use LaBelle 107. I've always used this. This stuff works great, and you can get this at virtually any hobby shop. Again, LaBelle 107. We're just going to apply a little bit to each one of the axles here. We're also just going to do a quick inspection, check everything underneath. Everything looks really good here. This, like I said, this engine was packed really well. The assembly is all clean. And I'm just going to get all of the styrofoam out so we can run. Because clean trains and well-lubricated trains are happy trains. Let's program this engine and look at all the cool things that it does. The first thing I'm going to do is remove this magnetic dome cap. This exposes the program and run switch as well as the Bluetooth on and off switch. Because this engine can run right out of the box with Bluetooth or traditional transformer control. I'm going to operate this engine with my legacy control system, so we need to program an engine ID into the engine. We're going to flip the program and run switch to the program position. And we're going to set the engine address to number 18. Here's the moment of truth. Are you ready? Drum roll, please. That's right. It's just me in this room. Listen to that beast. The engine has three speakers, one in the engine and two in the tender for that stereo sound effect. Flip our engine switch back to the run position. My favorite feature on this new Vision Line Class A is the startup sequence. This is a brand new thing from Lionel. It actually debuted with the Strasburg 90, which is still coming, by the way. It'll be here soon. But they put this extended startup feature into this Norfolk and Western Vision Line Class A. Listen to this.
Channel Brakeman, NW1218. We're showing 90 pounds on the rear of the train. Take out 20 for initial terminal brake test.
That's a roger. 20 pound reduction given. Checking for leakage, over.
Roger, showing 20 pounds. Welcome to the train. Brakeman out.
Awesome. Just awesome. This engine has a ton of smoke output as well. And listen to this whistle. Haunting. Hold up a second. I think this is worthy of a whistle battle. What do you think? Should we grab the reigning champion? Vision Line Big Boy 4014 versus the Vision Line Norfolk and Western Class A. Let's do it. It's time for the whistle battle. Our contenders today, the brand new Lionel Vision Line Norfolk and Western Class A and the reigning champion, the Lionel Vision Line Union Pacific Big Boy 4014. Are you ready? We're going to start things off with our Class A. Here we go. And now our reigning champion, the Big Boy. It's going to be a hard call. One more time. Our Class A. And the Big Boy. Let me know. Leave me a comment. Which engine won the whistle war? The Class A 1218, Norfolk and Western, or the Union Pacific Big Boy 4014? Leave your votes in the comments below. I want to highlight some of the crew talk in this engine because it's really neat. You have that road-specific crew talk.
This is NW1218 for Norfolk. Ready to make our pull. Swing in permission to occupy the main. Over. Please hold at your location. Go full power.
We also have some newer sounds on the train sound side of things.
Better tend to that fire while we're waiting in Columbus. It's going to be a hard pull ahead.
See how they said Columbus there?
Going to be here a while. Norfolk is holding here for number 90. She's running 20 minutes late.
One of the last features to go over is the force coupler. The coupler on the back of the tender is actually mechanical, and it relays data to the motherboard. This data tells the train engine if it's pulling a heavy string of cars or nothing at all, like right now. You can hear how it's relatively light on the chuff. But wait till I couple up these cars. Did you hear the sound of the coupler when I hit it with the cars? I'll show you again. Pretty cool, huh? Do it one more time. Awesome. Now, if the engine takes off, you're going to hear the chuff get louder. Because it's pulling like 9 passenger cars. Pretty cool. Since this is the excursion version of the Class A 1218, I've coupled it up to these OCS passenger cars. Number 1218 is the only surviving example of the Class A fleet, and it's currently on display at the Virginia Museum of Transportation, located in Roanoke, Virginia. The engine ran excursions in the late 80s into the early 90s, and was, at the time, the most powerful steam engine in the world. The engine is now the second most powerful steam engine. Can you guess which one is number one? 4014 Big Boy, of course. The Big Boy just seems to win at everything, doesn't it? In real life, the Class A is 121 feet long, 16 feet tall, and weighs nearly 1,000,000 pounds. Huge. Before running its excursions in the late 80s, the Class A was built for fast freight service. The train would run at over 70 miles an hour. You know what we have to do now? We're going to have to see what that looks like. Do you think this engine's going to fly off my layout? I really hope I don't break this thing. We were just starting our celebration together, our two-year celebration, and here I go, running this train engine at full speed around this curve. What could possibly go wrong? We're gonna do it anyway.
We're going to max speed, 70 miles an hour, efficient line Class A. Why do I do these stupid things?
Since we are running Norfolk and Western tonight, I figure we'll fill the layout with Norfolk and Western engines. Joining our newest engine is the famous 611. And since excursion service seems to be our theme tonight, I have the 611 coupled up to these brand new Lionel Strasburg Railroad passenger cars. If you've been to the Strasburg Railroad in the last 2 years, chances are you might have seen the 611. You may have even seen it in action. I also have the unshrouded J-Class, pulling the N&W passenger cars. These are your Madison cars, your more traditional looking passenger cars. We're featuring the Lionel Joshua Lionel Cowan Edition Y6B, which we ran in our last video. If you like big steam engines and want to see even more than you're seeing tonight, check out my last video where I run all of my articulated steam engines. I have the Y6B pulling a big freight train tonight, so that we'll have the freight train running and the passenger train running on the top line. But I wanted both of these big Norfolk and Western engines to run right next to each other. And don't worry, I didn't forget my diesel fans. I like diesel engines too. We have the Norfolk and Western FM Trainmaster running on the lower main line. And this is pulling a string of coal cars. The engine passing over the bridge is always one of my favorite scenes on the layout. So what did you think of this Lionel Vision Line Class A? Pretty amazing engine, but leave me a comment and let me know what you thought. As always, a huge thank you to all of my subscribers and everyone who's been supporting this channel. My name is Chris, and this is RBP Trains. We'll see you next time.